India's fight against polio began in the backdrop of an estimated 2 lakh cases of polio paralysis every year. The polio virus, transmitted through contaminated water and food, affected mostly children to cause death or irreversible paralysis. The magnitude of the disease and the lifelong misery it caused was huge. India's resolve to stop polio was greater. In 1985, India introduced oral polio vaccine into the Universal Immunization Program, which covered the entire country. A strong political commitment, matched by resources, steered the long and arduous journey. India introduced mass polio vaccination campaigns in December 1995. Since then, 2 nationwide and multiple sub-national rounds are held every year. In 1997, the World Health Organization launched what is today the most sensitive surveillance system for polio virus anywhere in the world, the National Polio Surveillance Project, with a network of 40,000 health facilities reporting nearly 60,000 paralytic cases annually and 8 WHO-accredited laboratories testing specimens. In 1999, India expanded fixed-site polio campaigns, introducing house-to-house immunization to ensure maximum coverage. Within 4 years, India and the world marked an important milestone. The last case of type 2 polio virus in Aligarh district of West Uttar Pradesh in October 1999. The risk from one of the 3 types of polio viruses was now gone forever. By the year 2001, of the 35 states and union territories in the country, 33 stopped polio transmission. High population density, poor sanitation, refusal to polio vaccine and hard-to-reach areas made polio transmission unstoppable in parts of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. UNICEF set up a social mobilization network in 2002 to address community refusal to polio vaccine. The community mobilizers counseled families and garnered support of the local community and religious leaders. The network, spanning over 526 blocks of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, has generated acceptance and demand among the very population which resisted or did not consider polio vaccination necessary. Rotary-initiated Ulema's committee ensured continued support of religious leaders and institutions as part of the special underserved strategy, which focused on mobilizing the vulnerable populations. India continued to report periodic outbreaks of polio as it fought an intense battle against polio, responding to seemingly impossible challenges with a series of innovative strategies. To protect children as early as possible, newborns were tracked and immunized. Transit vaccinators immunized children at bus stands, railway stations, on trains, marketplaces, and important road intersections. The migrant populations who often missed immunization due to their transient nature were mapped and vaccinated. The focus was on brick kilns, construction sites, slums and nomads. The program capitalized on huge congregations during festivals and fairs to mobilize the most vulnerable communities and populations. The special Kosi River plan was introduced to reach children with polio vaccine in the access-compromised areas of central Bihar. Under the guidance of the India Expert Advisory Group for Polio Eradication, the program introduced the monovalent oral polio vaccines in 2005, which helped curtail to record low levels the most dangerous type 1 polio virus, which accounted for 95% polio cases in India till 2006. In 2009, with 741 cases, India still had half of the world's polio cases. Experts termed India as the most difficult place for polio eradication, predicting it would be the last country to stop polio. But India did not relent. The program identified the last bastions of polio, a holistic approach to address polio-associated risk factors in these 107 blocks of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, focused on increasing routine immunization coverage, promoting exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months, hygiene, sanitation and diarrhea management with zinc and ORS. Simultaneously in 2010, India researched and introduced the bivalent oral polio vaccine, an extremely efficacious vaccine which tackled both types of polio viruses, type 1 and type 3, together. The year saw a sharp decline in the number of polio cases from 741 in 2009 to 42 cases in 2010. Globally, the demand for bivalent oral polio vaccine increased, and a shortage was inevitable. The domestic vaccine industry rose to the occasion to ensure a steady supply of bivalent oral polio vaccine for the polio campaigns in India. On 13th January 2011, when this two-year-old was crippled by polio in Howrah district of West Bengal, an emergency response was rolled out with lightning speed within 6 days. The scale, intensity, and quality of the response ensured that it remained the last case of polio in India. The war against polio had now become relentless. The state governments, and particularly the district magistrates of the high-risk areas, provided an extraordinary leadership to make sure maximum coverage during the polio immunization campaigns. The coverage exceeded 99%, an operational feat. In April 2011, India declared polio as a public health emergency. The program started putting in place a robust emergency preparedness and response plan to respond to any case of polio anywhere in the country. As days, months, and a year passed by without any fresh case of polio, on 24th February 2012, the World Health Organization removed India from the list of polio endemic countries. India's progress from half the world's polio paralysis in 2009 to zero within 3 years awed the world. Polio is gone from India, a magnificent achievement and proof of the capability of a country to succeed when it truly takes to heart the mission of protecting its people from this vicious disease. A polio scare on 11th October 2012 in Darbhanga district of Bihar activated and tested the program's emergency response mechanism, which geared up to respond at an unbelievable speed of 3 days. The scare lasted only 6 hours, but was a reminder that the risk of polio persists. As long as there is polio anywhere in the world, there is risk of polio coming back to India. The country stepped up vigil. Polio immunization posts came up along the international borders with Pakistan, Nepal, Bangladesh, Bhutan, and Myanmar. Travelers to and from the polio endemic and reinfected countries are being asked to take polio vaccine. To sustain the gains, the entire polio program machinery is now geared to boost routine immunization coverage. The story of polio program is inspirational. It gives India the confidence that every last child, even in the remotest corner of the country, can be reached with life-saving vaccines offered under routine immunization. Moving forward for polio-free certification, India accomplished another Herculean task of surveying more than 90,000 health facilities across the length and breadth of the country to identify laboratories with polio infectious material in a short span of 6 months. India's phenomenal achievement today was not possible without the tireless efforts of 2.3 million vaccinators, millions of community mobilizers and health workers who tapped on the doors of each of the 209 million households to immunize 170 million children round after round, year after year. The achievement today is of the entire country, all parents, community leaders, religious leaders, and all those who supported the program selflessly. The dedicated and seamless partnership with the World Health Organization, Rotary, and UNICEF. India has stamped out polio, but the country is vigilant. Today, India celebrates this monumental milestone with pride, confidence, and a greater resolve that the country will continue its effort until global polio eradication to ensure that polio does not come back to cripple and devastate the lives of its children.